They are an awfully long way away, those targets. 1,000 yards, and the 100 finest full-bore shooters in the country are shooting them today for the Queen's Prize, the grandest award in British target rifle shooting. It's a summer event that ranks alongside the Wimbledon tennis, the Henley Regatta and the various golf championships. So, what do you have to do to win?
They'll be shooting 2 sighting shots and 15 to count at 900, followed by 1,000 yards. So the total at each range is 75. So 150 is the maximum that can be scored here. They then add that to their second stage, which they shot yesterday afternoon, to get a total score out of 300. And the winner of the highest score is the winner of the Queen's Prize.
The shooters take their positions for the first leg, a piffling 900 yards. The butt markers drive out to the butts. The spectators queue for ice cream.
Well, we're down to the last 100 of our finest marksmen who will be competing in the Queen's Prize final. And probably 2,000 or 3,000 visitors. So the camp's just starting to warm up now, with people starting to flood onto the ranges to witness what is a terrific spectacle. I mean, you know, the results are printed in the broadsheets, the Times and the Telegraph. It's a bit dry, if truth be told, and doesn't really capture the magic of the competition, which is very evident today.
It is all part of the Imperial Meeting, a 4-week-long festival of shooting at Bisley, which has people camping and living on site. It's Glastonbury, but with rifles instead of music. It culminates in the Queen's Prize.
You know, there isn't a person who started this week, you know, the 1,100 people who were shooting at the beginning of this competition, who didn't dream of sitting in that chair and getting chaired off the range by the other 1,099, if you see what I mean. So that's... This is the big deal for us.
In the blustery conditions today, nobody is prepared to predict who is going to win.
Often, if it's benign weather up here, then those who squeak in by the skin of their teeth from yesterday don't get a look in. But I think anybody could win it here.
Unlike Henley, Wimbledon and the golf, the Imperial Meeting at Bisley is not televised. Well, except by us.
Yeah, but for the television audience, probably the best thing that we would ever do is to have shoot-offs where people shoot side by side and you see the targets come up together, and then, you know, you can see how well each are doing. A little bit, in a way, similar to the way the archery folks do it in the Olympics. That, for us, would be a change of a competition that is started in 1860, and so it depends a little bit on how urgent we feel that need to attract the TV audience. I personally am quite impressed with the ball tracker at golf, and I think it would be very interesting to devise something not dissimilar for rifle shooting at long range, because people would then begin to understand that actually the bullet arcs about 15 or 16 feet above the straight line between the end of the target and the end of the barrel. And then, of course, as there's wind, it sort of starts pointing towards 3 targets away, and then it swings around in a nice curve and hopefully hits the bullseye. So there's those type of things that we could think about.
At the halfway point, as the shooters move to the 1,000 yard position, some people are keen to make themselves comfortable.
It's a little bit old, actually. I think it's an antique. We found it in our clubhouse and we decided to bring it down so we could plot for our friend.
Another spectator has a special reason to be here today.
I have my father's Queen's Prize gold medal and badge, which he won here 60 years ago today. He didn't only shoot here, he was a member of English 2020 and also City Rifle Club. I was actually 2 months old when he won the Queen's Prize.
So what was Bisley like 60 years ago?
Nowhere near so much technology. Those days, to support your rifle, you just stuck your arm through the sling and that was it. None of these special jackets and special eye patches and all this sort of thing. It really was skill, luck and judgment.
A great deal goes into making this day work, and one of the big aspects of the day is safety.
In a lot of respects, actually, having 1,100 people on camp all with rifles, particularly 300 or so youngsters, actually, is in theory a security nightmare. The reality is it's anything but that. It's one of the safest places to come because everybody is carefully disciplined, very carefully organised, they've been carefully trained, and there's a great deal of infrastructure that actually makes shooting the safe sport that it really is.
Towards the end of the competition, the crowd gets a clearer idea about who is going to win. Many of the spectators here have been competing in the week, and they are well informed, especially about David Calvert, currently top of the leaderboard.
He has won before, don't know when, but this morning he won the St George's prize on a tie shoot, as well as the Conan Doyle on a tie shoot. They did a tie shoot this morning for that, so he won it on that as well, so it'd be a pretty good day if he won this as well. And he's currently a few points ahead, and three shots to go, I think.
At last comes the news everyone has been waiting for.
Calvert's got it.
We need a V-ball count.
I need a V count on these guys. There might be points errors.
294, 29 for Calvert.
Okay, Calvert can't lose. Really simple. One of ours, Royal Air Force. So we're going to have sore shoulders tonight.
The crowd is delighted. Wing Commander David Calvert is one of a handful of shooters to win the Queen's Prize twice, winning the first time in 2010, and he is typically modest about his achievement.
I just had more luck than everybody else on the day.
There is a big cheer for all the butt markers who've been spending this hot afternoon in a trench 1,000 yards away, marking the targets as they're shot. And then comes the bit that everyone has been waiting for, the cheering off of the winner, accompanied by the band. After his incredible achievement, David Calvert has a long evening ahead of him, taken on his chair from clubhouse to clubhouse around Bisley. While he does that, let's take our departure from the home of British shooting. You can visit nra.org.uk to find out more.